5, 4, 3, 2.
The first ice hockey team in El Paso was the El Paso Raiders. It was like seeing a brand new, unusual sport that everybody had seen on television, but they'd never seen in person. I'm sure everybody realized that it was a minor league team, but the players were unusually fast. I remember that. For a dollar, you could come see the game. That's incredible. We covered it when they first started to lay ice on the Coliseum, and we covered it when they started to put up the rink.
One thing that you constantly heard about was trouble with the ice.
The ice was soft, hard enough to play, but it was almost hit and miss on occasion. Well, they tried to market it just, you know, with advertising, and it succeeded for a time. They had good crowds, but it was never really the type of crowds that you would figure ought to be at the games. You know, there were 300-400 fans at a time.
Suddenly, one day you hear that the team's moving to Minot, North Dakota, and there's still 11 games to go in the regular season. That was it. The Raiders were gone.
It was almost like getting left at the altar when they left.
And after they left, there was no ice hockey in El Paso for like 20 years until the Buzzards came, and that was big.
There go the squids, Steve.
This is an incredible situation out here, folks. Incredible. Look at this.
This is what hockey's all about. Look at this.
The El Paso Buzzards are the inaugural President's Cup champions of the Western Professional Hockey League.
The first 2 years, there were two championships. I mean, these guys were like rock stars.
When you get 6,000 people in that Coliseum and the boards are extremely forgiving, the plexiglass is shaking nonstop. You look to the one corner, you got a hot tub full of girls.
You know, the "Hey goalie, you suck" chant probably still goes on today, but that got its start here in El Paso with the Buzzards.
There was definitely a lot of things that weren't right, if you will. It was, if you were an opposing team coming in, you didn't know what to expect. It would be blow up dolls, signs putting down the other team, especially goalies, in particular Martino.
The team, as good as they were, never went back and won that championship after that second season. And then the Hosella sell and Billy Davidson takes over, and you could just see that the franchise was going downhill.
You know, things change, players change, some different things going on with ownership, skates missing, paychecks not being able to be cashed.
Think about that, the owner stole his team's skates. When the team went under, you know, Davidson found himself, getting ready to serve jail time, and it was sad. It was sad to see how a team that at one time was on top of the El Paso sports world crashed and burned in a few years after.
Corey Herman played here for a year for the Buzzards, and he stuck around and stayed in El Paso. And, his true love to the game and his true love to the kids to help, you know, provide something for the kids to grow and give back to the game. And he was involved with the youth program right from the beginning, which now, you know, built up to a Junior A team and hopefully more.
We basically brought the Rhinos here to help build the youth program. Like, nobody ever knew before we bought the junior team that junior hockey existed, and that you had to play junior hockey to get your NCAA scholarship, and that all the Buzzards that were here for 7 years played this type of hockey.
There's some travel teams below us for the younger kids, and you know, everyone's trying to work their way up to play on the junior team, and then kids down here, you know, they do a great job of marketing and getting people down here, and it's just a great place to play.
You know, what they've done in the past 4 or 5 years is absolutely unbelievable. The Herman brothers, Corey in particular, have saved hockey in El Paso.
Hit him, Bone, hit him!
Break my rat race world, doesn't taste just like it should.
Don't
we big city sheep?
Jeff on Pilatic. To the near side, Rich Dell. He's got one guy to beat, and he scores! Whoa!
Marcus Ellis, Tyler Rich Dell. Whoa! Rhinos get it back again. Poland, shot, save. Nice pass. Frankie Petula goes score! Rich Dell, another big finish check on the boards. Ouch.
Don't deny purifies the man on the golden throne. Get the time that made you lie and realize you're all alone. Now you're throwing stones at some old bag of bones and you can't even knock him down. One last thing that you should know, I can tell you without a sound, right there's a door.
Long puts it back in, he scores! Rhinos forechecking. 3-on-2, front circle, slides it, puts it in the score!